Hi everyone. I'm in transaction code SE37 and I have clicked on the overview button to see the function group overview. Now we will see how this global variable works in the function group. I have purposely set breakpoints at two places in each of the function modules. And now let us execute this set group function module. I'll pass the value 002 over here and we'll execute it. Now, if you see in this debugger, the value which is passed is 002 and it gets assigned to 002 and we'll end the function module now. Let's go back over here and select the next function module in the function group and click on execute. I will pass value 00301 over here. Change value I will pass as 123456 and let's execute it. Sometime back we had passed set the value for G underscore group, which is a global variable. And now if you see it is set as blank. Reason is you came back and you selected another function module and you execute it. So that's what happens within the same function group. If you execute multiple function modules, the global variables which were set by earlier execution will be reset with every new execution within SE37. So you need to remember this. And that is why I purposely executed it. So now it will consider the value I group as 01 and execute the function module. You see over here, there are like how many 156 entries which have been selected. And this new change has been passed over here and 156 is the entry over here. Now let's go back and let's open a new session, SE38, and let's create a new program, ZTMM call function. Hence, executable program, let's save it, local object, and let's define two variables, LT underscore Mara, type table of Mara and LV underscore change type char 10. Now let us call these two function modules in sequence. ZTMM set group. I will first pass the value as 002 to the group and then let me call the get material function module. I'll pass the value 001 and here we'll pass LT Mara and change is LV change value which we have to just pass for some testing purpose to see what values are displayed and let's activate it. I'll put a breakpoint at each place over here. And let's just execute it. Basically, intention of this exercise is to know how this global variable works. Now, if you see over here, the input value is passed as 002. This is blank over here. If you see, the value has been set to G group. Now, let's just come over here in the function module. And let's just go to this include top include of the function group and let us do one magic over here. I'll just put curly brackets and then put G underscore group. Oh, not this one, sorry. master program. This is the master main program. And so the main program name is SAPL followed by the function group name. And let's put GROUP over here. So if you see the value of the global variable of a function group is accessible using the function group program name, which is SAPL followed by the function group name in brackets and then G group. This is this can be accessed using a field symbol. We'll see how to do that in the next video. And let's now proceed ahead. Now we have come inside this next function module. And if you see now the I group value is 001. And now if you see, because we have called both these function modules in the same session in one report program, these two values are populated over here. And this has been set by the previous function module call. And this is important because this is primarily used in most of the bodies to change substandard function module values which are there in global parameters. So you should know this. And now let's see how the function module behaves. Because this G underscore group is set, it will fetch the value for the G group is 001. So now let's see the ITMARA table. Now if you see over here, the field MATKL, the values which are being fetched is for 002. And if you see the input parameter which was passed was 001. However, it has picked up for the global parameter as per the conditions which have been defined. So this is how the global parameter value, the global data variable value in the function group is, can be used across multiple function modules. So earlier when object-oriented programming was not there and static variables were not there, these global variables which are available in the function group, which are available in this overview over here in these fields, these variables were used to pass value between these multiple function modules. And when we deal with BAPI in our next coming videos, we will be able to use them and make use of them even in substandard function modules. And then over here, the export parameter value and the change value is set. And you come back in the main program. So this is how we saw how the global variable can be accessed across the function modules, and also how to access this global variable using the function group name and by using the field symbol. How to use that we will see later on in the next video. So that's it from my side. Keep watching my videos. Thank you. Bye.